We begin tonight with some breaking news in rugby league after a marathon investigation which started last summer. The first player has been charged with taking performance-enhancing drugs. And even more alarming, Canberra Raiders winger Sandor Earl is also accused of trafficking them. Let's go straight to Adam Hawes at NRL headquarters now. And Adam, while we expected something this afternoon, this has still come as quite a shock.
Yeah, big shock, Sandra. No one saw this coming. Today, after 7 months, the ASADA investigation has its first scalp. Canberra Raiders winger Sandor Earl has accepted an infraction notice for admitting peptide use, CJC 1295, using and trafficking that peptide has seen him. He admitted that to ASADA yesterday. The NRL has acted swiftly today, calling a press conference late in the afternoon. He has been provisionally suspended from the Raiders. He has 10 days to challenge that decision at a tribunal if he so wishes. It's understood the use of this peptide and trafficking happened when he was at Penrith in 2011, although David Smith, the CEO, wasn't exactly forthcoming in all the details at this stage. Let's hear from the CEO now.
The charge has been laid against CJC 1295. We'll work through over the next 10 days. There's a series of charges against the use and trafficking of that particular peptide. We'll work through the charges with Sandor and his lawyer over the next 10 days, and then he'll either elect to go to a tribunal or he'll elect to accept the charge of the NRL.
Adam, these are sensational charges. So what are the potential penalties that he's facing?
Well, Sandra, for using illegal peptides, it carries a 2-year suspension under the WADA code. For trafficking, that doubles. It's 4 years. Now, Earl has actually signed to play in French rugby next year. He's going to leave the NRL. But this, of course, would transcend all codes. So if the suspension is coming, he wouldn't be able to play French rugby. Now, the talk now is if he's admitted to trafficking, has he implicated other NRL players? That's the real buzz in rugby league at the moment. And also, where does it leave the Cronulla Sharks? Because, of course, CJC 1295 has been linked to the Sharks from the start, although CEO Dave Smith was at pains today to say that ASADA is still in continuing that investigation and there's no evidence in front of him to issue any more infraction notices at this stage. So a breaking story. We'll have plenty more in sport.
You will. Plenty to play out on this story, Adam. We'll cross back to you again shortly as this story develops.